What's up, kings and queens? I'm HD Clark, and yes, we are in the mix. As you can see, I done switched it up a little bit today. We're not on a pier, we're not at the beach. We're at Alligator Alley, dodging alligators and trying to catch some fish, all while trying to get some pickup shots as well. Killing two birds with one stone. But that's not gonna stop what we need to be doing, so let's get right to it. Today's discussion topic is, how long should you allow your adult children to live at home? And should it matter if it's a son or a daughter? What's your thoughts? Let me know. Oh, and I'm about to catch a beast too, believe that.
Consistent with what are they doing? What are they contributing to the household? What are they contributing to life? Some kids at a certain age do very well on their own and out there, and sometimes they have to come home, you know, to get themselves to a certain place where they can be back out on their own. But when they are at home, what are they contributing to that? What are they doing with their life?
I think grown children should either be in school or living on their own. I think at least until the age of maybe 24, and that's pushing it for me.
Nowadays, more young adults from 18 to 34 years old live with their parents than with a wife or husband. What's more, 25% of those from 25 to 34 who live together with their parents neither work nor study.
Oh yeah, I told y'all. I told y'all I was gonna catch a beast, didn't I? I told you, didn't I tell you? Didn't I tell you? Didn't I tell you? What the fuck is this? Oh, hell no. I caught a turtle. Ew! Ah! Look at his neck!
Personally, I believe, okay, perfect case scenario. If there's nothing wrong with the child, like, you know, they don't have any, you know, disabilities, physical or mental, then, you know, we're talking about a child or an adult that, again, there's nothing wrong with. They're perfectly capable of working or going to school. And in my house, if they're doing those things, then they're welcome to stay until they complete whatever goal it is that they're working on.
If you have the ability to move out, whether that be going to school or just moving to an apartment, maybe a little dingy apartment, there's a lot to learn when you have to go pay your own electric bill and gas bill. You know, that alone, there's no free internet anymore. You don't just get to use the parents' car. Okay, you got to do your own dishes, so it forces you to be disciplined. And it's crazy is that this is, yeah, it's stressful. Going into the unknown is very stressful, but it's not stressful enough where it pushes you over the edge.
I would have to say that it depends, and to each his own. If you have that child out there that's not in college, not in technical school, not trying to do something to better their situation, and you're the mom, AKA Bank of America, then they need to get out. You need to cut that cord. But if they're in school, they're in college, go ahead and allow them to graduate. Set them up for success. Allow them to become more solid, more stable before you kick them out.
Well, I got a boy and a girl. My son didn't leave home till he was 22. And my daughter left when she was 18. Both of their circumstances was different. At the age of 18, my son was working. He offered to pay one of the bills in the house, so he was allowed to stay till he was 22. My daughter, on the other hand, didn't want to pay no bills. She wanted to come in and out as she pleased. She thought her boyfriend was going to spend the night in my house, so we had a discrepancy there, and she left when she was 18.
Well, it don't matter, because my kids stay with me, but they help me with everything, so it really don't matter.
My siblings, you know, due to circumstances, they're both back at home, and, you know, there's always reasons, you know, you may go through a divorce, or you may lose a job, or something may happen, but my dad always told me don't visit, but don't stay too long. And they're still at home. We're talking about 32, 34 years old with their kids. Everybody let out.
Back up. There's one thing if you at home with your parents alone, but you're saying they're at home with the parents and have the children there as well?
And their children there as well, yes. I got a divorce. I came home. I stayed 4 months. I'm gone. Didn't stay too long.
If you're stuck at home, if you're stuck in the same hometown that you've been in your entire life, you know where the local deli is, you know the baker's name, the laundromat's over here that your mom always takes you to, you're just familiar with everything. Your brain's not really looking for new opportunity. You get comfortable, all right? And when you're comfortable, there's no opportunity.
You're at home. There has to be a purpose for you being there. If you don't have any purpose for being at home, but just to lay around and have a place to sleep, you ain't working, you ain't going to school, you're not contributing to the household, then it's time for you to go when you get 18, 19, 20. But if you're an adult and you're in between jobs or, you know, you've had some crisis in your life, you should be able to come home for a minute. But while you're there, you're contributing to the household.
However, if you are, you know, an adult, you're in my house, you want to, you know, come and go as you please, and I actually have two adult children, so I have some experience with this. Anyways, if you are disrespectful to the rules of the house, regardless to, you know, how rigid you might think those rules are, then you gotta go. I don't care, girl, boy, you gotta go.
I really don't think it's a set mandatory age when they should leave, but at least 18. So if they feel they grown and they want to get out on their own, let them spread their wings. If they need a little time to establish some money or whatever to get themselves together for when they move, they'll be all right, then so be it.
You're not going to college. When you turn 18, you have to get out. If you're going to college, when you get out of college, you can't come back to my house. You have to get out. Why? Because I am 39. I have two adult children, one that's about to be an adult and another young adult. I want to live my life without having my children sitting up there telling me what to do, running me, bossing me.
I prefer my grown kids, which I have now. My two oldest ones live on their own. They have their own bills. They live on their own. They have their own cars. They pay everything on this by themselves. My youngest one is 18. She's heading to college to California, and I have an empty house on.
That's my beast. So they can be 40 and 50 still living.
No, I'm not saying that long enough.
So when does the point come when they have to be put out?
My daughters are it's like 24. So I'll say before they turn 30.
So what happens at 30 if they don't have a job? You going to put them on the streets?
No, I'm going to put my kids on the street. But
so
I'll have to set some rules that they'll have to get a job and then they'll have to move.
But at 30.
I'm staying home at 30.
But if 30, if they don't have a job, then what?
They'll have to find somewhere to go. But so I'm going to put them out on the streets. No, I'm going to do that. That wouldn't be a mom. I couldn't put my kids
out. Right. So listen, I need you to understand then. So if they know that you would never put them out on the street, they also know that they really don't have to worry about ever having to find a job or a place to stay in because you're never going to put them out.
I said you can't never go back home, but don't
It's good
just
to always
marinate
have
there forever. You know,
it's good to always be able to come back home for it to be like a pit stop.
Temporary, but then if you enable them, they will be there forever. They will be grown men, grown women.
So in your opinion, why do you feel they're still there?
Because they're enabled. Because nobody's
so
making
them.
So
that's on your parents, correct?
Yeah, that's them, and I'm a different kind of parent. I got grown.
My oldest child, I thought that I was doing them more good than harm, but my oldest child had to move back home, was not able to work, had fallen sick, and she had the hardest time accepting help from anyone, and not even just anyone, accepting help from me. Why? Because mommy said, you always have a job, you always save up money, you don't depend on anyone, and when you leave the house, you don't come back. So I really did her more harm than good. Does it matter if it's your son, your daughter, male or female? It should not matter. But the reality is, every parent has a child that they favor just a little bit more.
So, you know, as long as you're there and you're able to hold up your end and you're working, you're going to school, you're paying your way, and you're being respectful of the house and, you know, doing your chores, you're welcome to stay.
Johnny. Ain't no monster, but he'll do.